Hi, and welcome to Tarantulas with Shanti. I hope that you're all doing well out there as we approach midwinter. Just think, spring may not feel like it, but it is right around the corner. I have just finished up my Fatal Fangs recordings, and so I have a few more of the reject clips that are feedings, and I'm going to play them here as the third in the series of Fatal Fangs 2 rejects. This will be the final one. I have made a clip that's 2 minutes long. That would be if I even perchance and in a million years made it to the final round. I have one that's a minute. That would be if I made it that far. And then I have three clips that are 30 seconds for the first three rounds. And I'm good to go and I'm satisfied. So I'm gonna move on and have other projects to work on and put more attention into other things that I'm doing with my channel. I do have some bad news I wanna share with you today. I have this little male Acanthus guria geniculata who's been in my care for a few months. The owner of the female that I was gonna pair him with is my friend Jonathan, who did the hot sauce challenge with me. And I'm tarantula sitting Jonathan's teas. And so this little male was a breeding loan from one of our Facebook friends. And the female, she was in pre-molt and she didn't molt and didn't molt and didn't molt. She wasn't interested in the pairing. And so we kept him, hoping that, you know, she would molt, and finally she did, and she started eating, and yesterday she finally got to the point where she was not interested in food anymore, so it was time to try it out. But then when I checked on the male, who had been refusing food for about 2 or 3 weeks, he was very shaky, didn't want food, and his abdomen was kind of shriveled. I posted some photos of him on Instagram and I contacted his owner. I'd contacted her once before, a couple weeks ago, letting her know, you know, that the female just molted. So I don't know how viable he still was because he hadn't made a sperm web. So anyway, this morning he was unfortunately in death curl. And he has passed away now. I can show him to you. He's a gorgeous boy, very sweet, and he was just a very gentle tarantula. He's quite large. Yeah, such a sweet boy. Every time I would open his enclosure, he would start to come out. Yeah. He's kind of a little bit of a shadow of what he was, because he was a monster. And his little bum is small now, and he was a lot bigger. You can see there's my hand. He's a big boy. I will get a measurement on him and show you, you know, how big he is. His rear leg is very stiff. But you're looking at, yeah, he's a big boy. I mean, I would go so far as to say he's probably 7.5, maybe even 8 inches, because that's 7.5 right there without his back leg stretched out. It won't move. You can see it's bent up and it's stuck like that. So this was a big boy. And rest in peace, little guy. Anyway, I still feel sad regardless. Even if there was maybe nothing I could have done, I'm getting a little better at not second guessing myself all the time. It's just part of it, you know, losing them. It's sad. I wanted him to go back to his human. He was scheduled to go back with her on Monday, but we didn't quite make it, so I'm going to put the little guy in the freezer for her so she can have him preserved in any way that she wants. Now that the depressing part is over, let's go ahead and watch that feeding video.
Thank you.